Anansi and the Pot of Wisdom. Once upon a time, when humanity had still not discovered the fire or invented the wheel, in a small village of Africa, there lived a man-angel called Anansi. Anansi was the son of the mighty king of the sky, Nyame. Anansi was a very curious person and loved to learn new things. This came into the notice of his father, who decided that it was finally time to gift him the Pot of Wisdom.
Anansi, my son, your quest for knowledge has pleased me. I have decided that I would like to give you this Pot of Wisdom.
Wow!
This pot will teach you a lot in your life. But remember, the only thing to do with good wisdom is to pass it on.
Anansi, who was mesmerized by the pot, did not quite hear that.
Thank you, Father. I will keep this pot safely and learn well.
Over the time, Anansi learned something new every day from the Pot of Wisdom. He would try to create something new each time.
Look what I've made, Father!
Great! I am proud of you, my son. Why don't you share this idea with the villagers?
Share this too? No way! This is my creation, and no one gets to use it but me!
This worried Nyame, but he chose to not say anything and leave it to time. After a few days, Anansi learned how to light a fire. He was ecstatic and immediately sent a raven asking his father to come by to his tent. When Nyame arrived, he was very pleased to see the fire.
Father, I've created fire inside the tent. I don't need to live in the darkness, and I don't need to feel cold. I'll keep my body filled with light and heat.
Nyame smiled with pride.
You have no idea what you have achieved here, son. This discovery will take humanity to a whole new level. You must share this with the people immediately.
Father, it is only I who is making efforts to invent and discover. Do you think I would like to share my wisdom with the lazy humans of the village who are doing nothing about their struggles?
Nyame was astounded by Anansi's words. He realized that he could not keep quiet anymore.
Anansi, I was very happy that the rightful owner to the Pot of Wisdom was my dear son. However, I realize that I have made a mistake. Please return the pot. I will look for someone else who would be willing to share their wisdom with the world.
This made Anansi very angry. He immediately got up and said,
Father, I have hidden the pot in a place you can never find. It is far away from our village.
Nyame thought for a while and then said,
Anansi, you do not deserve to live amongst the humans. Leave at once and come back only when you have realized your mistake. And as for the pot, I will find it sooner or later.
Saying that, Nyame disappeared into thin air.
My father will never understand that the humans do not deserve the pot. I am going to make sure to hide it somewhere deep in the woods, where no one will ever find it.
Anansi took the pot out from its hidden place and left the house.
I deserve this Pot of Wisdom, and there is no going back.
Anansi went far into the deep woods. He searched high and low for the right place to hide the pot, but he didn't find any. And soon he was very tired and thirsty.
Oh, I'm so thirsty. Where do I find water? Is that a river? Yes! Oh, sweet, cold water. Here,
The riverbank was steep and slippery, and Anansi felt helpless. He was afraid that the Pot of Wisdom would fall from his hands and break.
Oh, how do I get there? This is very difficult.
Just then, Anansi heard a splash in the water. He looked to the side and saw a little child looking at him and smiling. The child was pulling a vine that was tied to a pot made of leaves, drawing water from the river. He slowly pulled the pot filled with water out of the river and gave it to Anansi. Anansi was amused and gulped down the water in a second as he was very thirsty.
Oh, thank you, little fellow.
Goo-goo!
Anansi cocked his head back.
Interesting. Well, thank you once again. I gotta go now.
Goo-goo!
Never mind.
Anansi turned and started to walk. After a while, he realized that the little boy was following him. Anansi did not like it at all.
Hey! Why are you following me?
Goo-goo!
No, Goo-goo! You need to go back to your tribe.
Goo-goo!
Anansi sighed and continued walking. The little boy kept following.
You seem to be a troublesome little human.
They kept walking until a huge tree was spotted. The tree had numerous branches spread in all directions. It was so twisted that it seemed like the perfect place to hide the pot of wisdom.
This looks like the perfect place to hide my precious pot.
Anansi decided to climb it. He held the pot in one hand and tried to grip the tree with the other. But he kept slipping down and was afraid he would drop the pot. The little boy, however, was very amused.
Goo-goo!
What is it?
Anansi turned to see the boy holding onto a vine right next to the tree. He gestured towards the pot and tied a knot in the vine.
Goo-goo!
Anansi was amused.
This could actually work!
He went to the tree, plucked out the vine, and did exactly as the boy had suggested. Then, he started his climb as the little boy watched. Anansi climbed high up the branch to the tallest part of the tree.
Oh, finally! The best place to keep the pot of wisdom. No one will ever find it. Even that little human can't see it.
Anansi looked down from there and saw that the little boy was making sand mountains and stroking outlines on sand to draw a river. Anansi kept staring at the boy. He realized that throughout his difficult journey, it wasn't the pot that had helped him, but the little boy. He was embarrassed over how foolish he had acted.
If this little human is so intelligent, even without the pot of wisdom, I wonder what the entire human race must be capable of doing. They just need some inspiration, some wisdom to be shared.
Anansi looked at the pot and finally made his decision.
The only thing to do with good wisdom is to pass it on. Yes, that's what Father had said.
Anansi came down from the tree and threw the pot in the river. The strong current of the river cracked it, and all the wisdom dispersed from it, moving towards the direction of the village. The little boy was confused.
Goo-goo!
Yeah, I know. Now, let's take you home.
And thus, Anansi, the man-angel, was finally ready to become the teacher of humanity. He taught them how to light a fire, make a wheel, and the methods of farming, too. He helped everyone, told stories to little children. Meanwhile, the knowledge and wisdom that was dispersed in the water from the pot of wisdom spread across the world amongst the people, making many of them wiser, intellectual, and readying them to become the most powerful species on Earth.
Thanks to Anansi, the wisdom travels far and beyond, teaching different people different things. Which is why no one person has all of the wisdom of the world. And that is why we share wisdom with each other when we exchange ideas. If everyone had all the wisdom, or if all the wisdom was kept intact with one person, the world would have never grown. Just like how a candle loses nothing by lighting another candle, knowledge increases by sharing, not by saving it.
Goo-goo.